I like on that. There's actually more people don't understand this, that the first degree black belt, the second degree black belt, the third degree black belt, those are just the instructors. They can't go out and teach anybody anything. Because they don't know. But when they come fourth degree, they're considered instructors after all that time. And usually that time is probably close to 15 to 20 years of training. So every time we get a fourth degree, it's significant. It's important for the school. For the idea that martial art is still learning, still alive, and not some of the stuff that's out there. Rex Roy, work then!
Rex, ready? Get up. Yank. Rex is Saba Mimke. Rex, welcome to our club.
I just wanted to say a couple quick things about Rex and my dad's right. He started at 4. He was in an anomaly. His parents knew about the program. I had literally trained with his grandfather when I was a kid. So they knew about the program. But he stayed through all of this thing. And he was the only little kid in his sparring class. Like, I don't want to have a kid's sparring class. I just had children. I don't want to do that race. I'm not going to do that race. And he did not leave. He kept coming and coming. I can do it. I can do it. Right? And he did. And then he went to me. Those are the Astros. Like, this is adult level now, right? This is tough. It's not juniors. He medals in junior black belt. He's elite, top four in the country. And he goes to men's. He turns around the same thing. And he did it. And he did it. And he did it. Right? And he did it. That's not easy to do. It's like 4 or 5 people that are able to do all of this plus that. And now this, right? So it's not that he's special. It's that you guys know he's special. It's just that special. And I mean, I wish Jeff was here to see it. I wish Jeff was here to see it. Because that's my brother. Because that's Jeff right there. He just reminds me of my brother in so many ways. So congratulations to you.
It's not the critic who counts. It's not the man who points out how a strong man stumbled, or the doer who leads could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who's actually in the arena, whose face is marked by dust, sweat, and blood, who strives valiantly in airs and comes short again and again, because there is no effort without air or shortcoming. But who actually strives to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasm, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at best in the end knows the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst if he fails, at least fails well.